Hello and welcome everyone. So in this video we are going to take a look on how we can access the HTML DOM. Okay, first of all, how the DOM look like. Now we are looking at the HTML document, which has a HTML opening closing. Inside you have a head, inside you have body, inside body you have a lot of things. You can have a div tag has a h1 paragraph, all the elements will be inside it, anchor tag, text and all, right? So how this the whole picture look like, this is the document. This look like a tree kind of a structure, right? So this is called as a DOM tree. And whenever we wanted to access a particular node, we are traversing from top to bottom. So look, okay, I want to just change the anchor tag, the link of this particular tag. I wanted to change the text coming in this H1 tag. So all these kind of a DOM manipulations you will be able to do using JavaScript APIs. But first of all, what is DOM? Document Object Model. So whatever the HTML being published on your browser, that is actually transpiled into this document object model, DOM tree, we are calling. This is how your, if you just split out into your nodes or the tags, HTML tags, then this is how your tree will look like. We have HTML inside your body, body will have a div, then consider something like this. So inside HTML, I have a body, inside I have a div. Div has a two childs, h4 and button. Okay, to access this DOM, we are going to cover everything about how to access the DOM, what is DOM, okay, all these things. So there is a document object provided by JavaScript, because we are going to access something from this document. So JavaScript will come into the picture. When you wanted to style something for this DOM, then styles it will come into the picture, CSS files. If you wanted to play around with the text, with the images, with the link, with all the kind of animations you wanted to play around with the data and text, then you will be using JavaScript to manipulate it. Because what JavaScript will do, it will try to iterate, it will try to find the node, it will change the link of anchor tag, it will change the image, it will change the inner HTML text of a particular node. So JavaScript will be able to do all these things using some JavaScript APIs. So first of all, what all DOM methods we have? DOM methods are nothing but those methods which are responsible for accessing the DOM and changing things for you. We consider this magic which is being performed here, like hello, then magic, right? So when I click on to this button, I'm changing something into this label and this label is getting changed. So you can see I have a button, I'm clicking onto the magic and it is doing document.getElementById. So there are many ways to access a DOM node. So this is one of them. So what I did is I'm providing ID selector app. So what I can do, I mean, you can put a class, you can put an ID. All these different methods are there in JavaScript to access a DOM, like document.getElementById, document.querySelector, document.querySelector, all document.getElementByTagName, by class name. All these methods are there to access the node. This is going to give you the first node which is having ID app. I mean, it is going to return you the single node. Query selector all will give you all the nodes having the ID as app. So you need to decide what you wanted to get, either a single node or array of node. Then in array of node, you just iterate onto them and just try to grab them. Okay, so we'll just quickly see what all different APIs we have, like document.getElementById. So what it does is it is going to just iterate onto this document model. It will see, okay, there is an app ID, and just put magic in the inner HTML of that. Okay, so document.getElementById, you just provide the id.innerHTML, will access the content of that DOM node and it will replace that property. So inner HTML, so easiest way to access a particular content of a DOM node, you can just do an inner HTML. Inner HTML will give you the value. So there are other ways also to do this, like document.getElementByTagName. So get element by tag name, get element by class name. So we can just talk about all these things. What are the different responsibilities they are having? Okay, I will just try to put some comments here, and inside comments we'll talk about them. Okay, document.getElementById. So find an element by element ID. document.getElementById tag name. Like tag name can be a simple these tags. I'm talking about the button tag, div, body, and all. These all are tags. And document.getElementByClassName, this is nothing but, okay, I wanted to put class name instead of this, so class app. So you can just use document.getElementByClassName. Okay, these are the different ways to access a DOM node. Now, what you can do is you can change the property behavior. If you wanted to change the attribute, if you wanted to change the inner HTML, or if you wanted to change the style. Okay, so there are many ways to do this. We just need to just care what we are going to do, what we are going to change. Are you going to change the some particular attribute, or you are just going to change the inner HTML of that? Okay, I will just try to summarize it. So inner HTML, I will just try to zoom it. So document.get element by ID. So what we are doing is document.get element by ID dot inner HTML. So new HTML content will be published here. So you can just say whatever you want, hello world. And this can be done in different ways. So document.get element by ID, it will just get the only single element, and then you will be able to do it. Okay. Now what you can do is it is going to give you the element. Okay. So what you can do is, so here you can just play around with this. Okay, what other things you can do? Element dot attribute. So attribute equal to, you can just put some particular value to a particular attribute of this DOM node. So get item, item dot length, attributes. So it will give you all the attributes of a particular DOM node. So another thing is, if you got the element, you can just do a style dot property. Now in this style, you can access any property, like I have a color property and I just wanted to change it to green. So what I'm doing is I'm accessing that particular DOM node and I'm playing around it. So in the HTML I changed the style of that particular DOM node, right? Even you can also set some property, element dot set attribute, and you just provide a key and value. Okay, I have attribute is data that text, and I'm just putting some value. Okay, so you can also change the attribute value, or you can add a new attribute to a DOM node. Okay, these are just different ways to access a DOM node and changing its inner HTML, changing its property, changing its style. Okay, you can also add and delete element, like these are actually DOM APIs which are provided us to create a new element, append the new element to the body, to the remove the element, and clear all these things, like document.create element, document.append child, remove child, replace child, document.write. So you can just look at any documentation, it covers everything. If you wanted to create a new HTML element, okay, you don't find something and you wanted to create some new element and append it to the document.body, then you will be able to do it, document.create element. Okay, so other things, let's cover the other things in the next video, because it will be too much in that case.